Welcome to English 2. My name is Amir Hussain Qureshi and I am your teacher for English 2. This is our third lecture and we are learning three-step writing process. And today we are going to learn writing business message. In our last lecture, we discussed planning. We discussed how to analyze a situation, how to gather information, how to limitize your information, and how to share a business message through a short story. In today's lesson, we are going to begin with writing business messages. So what are the learning objectives? Identify the four steps of being sensitive to audience needs when writing business messages. Explain how establishing your credibility and projecting your company's image are vital aspects of building strong relationship with your audience. Adapting to your audience. Being sensitive to your audience needs. It's necessary for anybody while he is communicating to his audience or customer to have a sensitive relation with his audience. जब कभी भी कोई भी शख्स अपनी audience के साथ communicate कर रहा होता है तो उसकी audience की needs के साथ एक sensitive relation का होना जरूरी है. How to adopt the sensitive relation? The first step is adopting the you attitude. सबसे पहले आप यू एटीट्यूड को अडॉप्ट करेंगे. व्हाट इज यू एटीट्यूड? ऑडियंस सेंटर्ड अप्रोच. सी ए सब्जेक्ट थ्रू योर ऑडियंस आइज. ये एक ऑडियंस सेंटर्ड अप्रोच है जहां पर आप चीजों को अपनी ऑडियंस के नुक्ताए नजर से देखते हैं. सिंपली रिप्लेस द टर्म्स दैट रेफर टू योर सेल्फ एंड योर कंपनी विद टर्म्स दैट रेफर टू योर ऑडियंस. वो तमाम टर्म्स जो आपकी तरफ रेफर करती हैं या आपकी कंपनी की तरफ रेफर करती हैं, आप उन्हें अपनी ऑडियंस की तरफ रेफर कर देंगे. हम एग्जाम्पल्स देखते हैं. ट्यूजडे इज द ओनली डे दैट वी कैन प्रोमिस क्विक रिस्पॉन्स टू परचेज ऑर्डर रिक्वेस्ट. वी आर स्वैम्प्ड द रेस्ट ऑफ द वीक. वी ऑफर MP3 प्लेयर्स विद 50, 70 और 100 GB ऑफ स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी. नाउ यू कैन सी इन दीज बोथ एग्जाम्पल वी हैव यूज्ड द वी प्रोनाउन फॉर कम्युनिकेटिंग विद अवर ऑडियंस. व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू change this we with you. If you need a quick response, please submit your purchase order request on Tuesday. You can choose an MP3 player with 50, 75 and 100 gigabytes of storage. Now in these examples, you are giving respect and honor to your audience. Be aware that you is more than just using particular pronouns. It is a matter of respecting and being genuinely interested in your recipients. You can use you 25 times in a single page. Avoid using you attitude while offering your opinions or reporting on something you have seen. जब कभी आप अपनी जाती राय दे रहे होते हैं या आप किसी ऐसी चीज के बारे में रिपोर्ट कर रहे होते हैं जिसे आपने देखा है, तो ऐसी सूरत हाल में यू को यूज करने से अवॉइड करना चाहिए. इसके अलावा ऑन सम ओकेजंस इट्स बेटर टू अवॉइड यूजिंग यू, पर्टिकुलरली इफ डूइंग सो विल साउंड ओवरली अथॉरिटेटिव और अक्यूजिंग. इसके अलावा जब कभी भी आपका बात करना और आप यू के जरिए बात करें और आपकी बात ओवरली अथॉरिटेटिव लगे या अक्यूजिंग लगे, तो ऐसी कंडीशन में भी यू का इस्तेमाल नहीं करना चाहिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू फेल्ड टू डिलीवर द कस्टमर्स ऑर्डर ऑन टाइम. Now in this example, you are accusing your audience. Instead of using this, write this: the customer didn't receive the order on time. Now in this sentence, you are giving respect and a comfortable zone to your audience. Maintaining standards of etiquettes. आपके और आपके customer के दरमियान relations में आदाब या अखलाक का लिहाज रखना बहुत जरूरी है. The environment where your customer and your audience will feel comfortable will help to communicate better. Good etiquette shows respect for your audience and helps foster a more successful environment for communication by minimizing negative emotional reaction. Here in these examples, the person is addressing to the audience in a negative way and where the audience or customer is not feeling comfortable. Once again, you have managed to bring down the website through your incompetent programming. You have been sitting on our order for 2 weeks and we need it now. What we have to do, we have to give respect and honor to our customer. Let's review the last website update to explore ways to improve the process. Our production schedules depend on timely delivery of parts and supplies, but we have not yet received the order scheduled for delivery 2 weeks ago. Please respond today with a firm delivery commitment. Now you can see in these two examples, you are giving a positive note and you are giving a comfortable zone to your audience where it is better for audience to communicate to. While in these examples where you address in a negative way to your audience and now your audience is feeling uncomfortable. If you know your audience well, a less formal approach might be more appropriate. अगर आप अपनी ऑडियंस को जानते हैं तो एक लेस फॉर्मल अप्रोच भी अपनी ऑडियंस के साथ कम्युनिकेशन के लिए बेहतर रहेगी. रिटन कम्युनिकेशन एंड मोस्ट फॉर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया जनरली रिक्वायर मोर टेक्ट देन ओरल कम्युनिकेशन. जब कभी आप किसी के साथ थ्रू रिटन मीडिया लिख कर कम्युनिकेट करते हैं या इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया के जरिए आप किसी से जब बातचीत करते हैं तो ये काम ओरल कम्युनिकेशन से थोड़ा मुश्किल है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, हम एक एग्जाम्पल देखते हैं जिसमें एक कस्टमर अपने एजेंट से अपने मसले पे बात कर रहा है लेकिन उसके एजेंट का जो रवैया है उसके लिए इंतहाई शर्मनाक है. हाय, आई ट्राइड इंस्टॉलिंग द फॉरकास्ट वायरलेस रूटर इन माय अपार्टमेंट बट आई एम नॉट गेटिंग एनी सिग्नल्स आउट ऑफ इट एट ऑल. यू कैन सी द कस्टमर इज ब्रीफली डिस्क्राइबिंग हिज प्रॉब्लम बट एजेंट सेज ओके Tell me what step you took and we'll see what you did wrong. Now you can see the customer where the customer has briefly described his problem. The agent, instead of addressing him in a positive way, the agent is accusing him of taking some negative or some wrong steps. Now what customer replies, what do you mean did wrong? I followed the instruction exactly. The router is obviously defective. Agent, well, we will see. Did you install the software before connecting the LAN cable as the manual says? Customer, of course I did. I just said I followed. You can see the customer is briefly describing his problem and saying that he has followed the instruction, but still the router is not working. On the other, the agent has begun his conversation by accusing the customer, which is something negative. What we have to do, now you can see in this example, customer. Hi, I tried installing the forecast wireless router in my apartment, but I am not getting any signals out of it at all. Again, the customer has briefly described his problem. Agent, I am sorry, you are having trouble. Let's go through your setup and see if we can find the problem. Now, the agent is addressing in a positive way and the customer will feel comfortable. Customer, great, thanks. Agent, first, can you tell me which of the small green lights on the front of the router are lit up? Customer, only the power light. All of the other lights are shown off. Now you can see the agent way of addressing his customer is helping them to communicate in a better way. Instead of using authoritative language or instead of accusing your customer or audience, you should adopt an approach where you can give respect to your audience, where your audience or customer will feel comfortable in communicating to you. Emphasizing the positive. Never try to hide the negative news, but look for positive points that will foster a good relationship with your audience. कभी भी किसी negative news को hide ना करें, बल्कि एक positive way में अपनी audience के साथ communicate करें. Like this, it is impossible to repair your laptop today. We wasted 300,000 advertising in that magazine. These two sentences are containing a negative news, but not in a good way, and these sentences are gonna affect in a negative way. Instead of writing these two sentences, write this. Your computer can be ready by Tuesday. Would you like a loaner until then? Our $300,000 advertising investment did not pay off. Let's analyze the experience and apply the insights to future campaigns. Now, in these two sentences, you are giving respect and comfortable zone to your audience, which is better for communication. If you are trying to persuade audience members to perform a particular action, point out how doing so will benefit them. अगर आप किसी particular action की बात कर रहे हैं, तो simply point out करें कि कैसे ये काम आपकी audience को फायदा देगा. Like in these two examples, where the point is not clear, we will notify all three credits reporting agencies if you do not pay your overdue bill within 10 days. I am tired of seeing so many errors in the customer service blog. Now in these two examples, you can see the information is not clear. The point is not clear. Well, here you can see paying your overdue bill within 10 days will prevent a negative entry on your credit record. Proofreading your blog postings will help avoid embarrassing mistakes that erode confidence in our brand. Now you can see the problem is clear here and the audience will get what is better for them. Using bias free language. Always use biased free language. You shouldn't be gender bias, racial and ethnic bias, age bias or disability bias. Gender bias, for example, instead of using mankind, use humanity. Instead of using manpower, use workers or workforce. Racial and ethnic bias, don't be racial and ethnic bias in your communication. And don't be age bias as well. Instead of saying someone is too old, use the word senior citizens. Give respect to your audience. And don't be disability bias as well. Adopting to your audience, building stronger relationship, establishing your credibility. किसी भी communication के लिए आपका और आपकी audience या customer के दरमियान एक strong relationship का होना बहुत जरूरी है. सबसे पहली चीज जो अहम है वो establishing your credibility, कि आप अपनी अहमियत आप अपने customer या अपनी audience के सामने वाज़ेह करें. ऐसे कौन से स्टेप्स हैं जो आपके लिए अपनी अहमियत बढ़ाने में मददगार रहेंगे. द फर्स्ट वन इज ऑनेस्टी. यू शुड बी ऑनेस्ट. ऑब्जेक्टिविटी. गिव इम्पोर्टेंस टू योर कस्टमर. अवेयरनेस ऑफ ऑडियंस नीड्स. यू शुड अवेयर ऑफ योर ऑडियंस नीड्स. क्रेडेंशियल्स, नॉलेज एंड एक्सपर्टीज. यू शुड हैव इनफ नॉलेज ऑफ थिंग्स. एंडोर्समेंट्स, परफॉर्मेंस, कॉन्फिडेंस एंड सिंसेरिटी. दीज थिंग्स आर going to help you in establishing your credibility and in help you in building a strong relationship with your audience. Projecting your company image. Your company's interest and reputation take precedence over your personal views and communication style. Most successful companies work hard to foster a specific public image, and your external communication efforts need to project that image. Many organizations have specific communication guidelines that show everything from the correct use of the company name to preferred abbreviations and other grammatical details. बाज औकात आपका कंपनी के बारे में कोई भी तासुर आपका आपकी ऑडियंस या कस्टमर के साथ रिलेशन को बिल्ड करने में बड़ी अहमियत का हामिल रहता है. देर आर सम companies that have their guidelines to follow. अगर आप किसी ऐसी कंपनी में हैं जिसकी कोई गाइडलाइंस हैं, आप उसको फॉलो करें. अपने सीनियर्स के साथ मिलें, उनसे बात करने का अंदाज सीखें, उनसे कम्युनिकेशन के तरीके सीखें, ताकि आपका आपकी ऑडियंस के साथ या आपके कस्टमर्स के साथ रिलेशन रिगार्डिंग योर कंपनीज इमेज स्ट्रॉन्ग रहे और आपकी ऑडियंस के लिए फिर आपके साथ कम्युनिकेशन में बेहतरी रहेगी.